Revelation 10, brother, because of you. Start at the 6th verse. This is your scripture. And because of you, you provoked this scripture to be read to the whole body in here tonight. And this is your taking home scriptures for all of this year to next year camp meeting. Your year didn't start in January. Your year start tonight. This is New Year's Eve night. New Year's Eve night is tonight. What did he say?
And swore in the name of, by him who lives forever and ever.
Who did what?
Who created the heavens and sky, and all they contain. And the earth and all that it contains.
And what?
And the sea and all that it contains.
He did what?
He swore.
That no what?
That no more time
should what?
Should intervene.
And there what?
And there should be.
No more what?
No more waiting or delay.
Y'all don't know how to praise God. I don't think you just heard that and understood that. The Lord has prophesied to the people that is in this house that even if you were in a position tonight where you couldn't physically get on the floor but your spirit man was laying down, he said, for you, prophesy this through my word, that there shall be no more time that shall intervene with what I have promised. For after this night, there shall be no more waiting and no more delays. You don't get what I'm saying. You didn't just hear what I said. You don't hear what I'm saying to you tonight. Said the Spirit of the Lord, I move time out of the way. I move time out of the way. And what you have been praying. woman already paid the price. This is your coming out year. It breaks for you. Tonight it breaks. Tonight, this threshing floor that I brought with me belong to you. Hello, Shanda. Cause your wait is over. Hey, Shanda. Hey, Shanda. And everything that God showed you, it was not your imagination. But the Lord said you weren't ready. But now your spirit is ready. Your heart is ready. Your motive is ready. Your mind is ready. And most of all, your prayer life is ready. You better come and shout at him. No more delay. No more delay. No more waiting. No more waiting. When I have a need, if I can't get to the church, if I'm not at home, all I need is a floor. Because I will turn every place I am into a threshing floor. Because if I get a floor, I got an answer. If I get a floor, I got the victory. If I can find me a floor, I got a breakthrough. I get ready to go. I gotta go. But when I was in the third grade, I remember my first fire drill. And they taught us in the third grade. They said when you in a house that's on fire, even if you don't see no flames, the minute you see smoke, they gave us two rules: drop and roll. They said that if you stay down low, you can see an exit out. Y'all ain't hearing me. They said, because the closest exit, the smoke gonna start being sucked in that direction. And what the Holy Ghost told me to leave with you tonight, that if you get on the floor in the midst of fire, you can see your way out. Y'all ain't hearing me. Y'all ain't hearing me. When the enemy hits your house, drop and roll. Oh, I learned that since last year. You ain't got to play with the devil. You say, Satan, the Lord rebuke you. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. Satan, God rebuke. Oh, you ain't gonna go?